Some of you sent me a video from a channel called Christian Princess. The woman's name is Katrina. She's from Europe, but she got a job in the United Arab Emirates a while back. She worked in a salon, and while she was there, she fell in love with a Muslim man. She started wearing the hijab so that she wouldn't upset his family. She thought they would get married and she would be fine as a Christian, but he wanted her to convert to Islam. So they ended up doing some studying. And the clip that people wanted me to see was about one beautiful day.
One beautiful day. I found David Wood. He popped out on my YouTube. I thought that this guy is the only person who understands me in my life. Because I was reading so many things about Islam, and my ex was saying all the time that that was wrong. I was watching his videos day and night. I kept it as a secret because as I was so naive, I thought that my ex does know about this person. The day came when I finally made a decision to inform him about this amazing person who knows every single reference, everything about the life of Muhammad and from the Quran. I said, okay, I have to tell you something. I have one person. I want you to study from him. I want you to listen what he has to say. Name of this person is David Wood. And he said, oh no, you found him.
Found me. I do have to correct the claim that I know so many references. I sound like that in my videos because I will spend hours or days preparing a video until it's exactly the way I want it. But after I post the video, I wipe my mind clean of most of the disgusting details. In other words, I read some messed up stuff in the Muslim sources and I think, wow, people need to hear about this. Then I make my video and I say to myself, now I don't have to think about this subject anymore because it's out there on YouTube. I did my job. I got the information into video form, so I'm done with it. And I forget most of it. But my videos are pure gold. Now, back to Katrina finding out that her boyfriend already knew about me.
I said, what? You know about this guy? He said, of course I know David Wood. He's like the worst. He makes jokes and he speaks lies and things. I said, how do you know about him? This was my surprise for you. Of course, he told me to not look at this man. And he said, all this time, I was just like, Ya Allah, just don't find David Wood. Don't allow her to see this guy. I think that my ex actually likes David Wood. But he keeps this secret in his heart. I'm telling you that actually Muslims like David Wood.
I've been thinking that for years. At first, I was wondering, why aren't any of the people who say they're going to kill me actually killing me? But then I started realizing that deep down, they love me. I think it's my swag. So, Katrina found my videos. She also found Somali Christian TV. That's Shino and Shania. They're both ex-Muslims from Somalia. She found Al-Fadi, another ex-Muslim. And she found Christian Prince. Meanwhile, her Muslim boyfriend was showing her Zakir Naik videos, and she was not impressed.
Of course, from the very beginning, he was sharing with me videos of Zakir Naik. And I told him, please, can you stop sending me this guy? He harms my IQ.
Zakir Naik harms everyone's IQ.
Then he would send me Ahmed Didat. He screams. Why he screams? I don't want... Do you have anyone else? He said, what? For everyone, these videos, it makes them realize, change their mind and come to Islam. Of course, I said, this? He said, yes, of course, but on you, this is not working. I mean, of course it's not working. He sent me Adnan Rashid and others, and the only person whom I was able to listen to, basically, was Shabir Ali. He was like calm and normal. It's just Zakir Naik.
So the only Muslim apologist she could take seriously was Shabir Ali, and he's the one they call a heretic. Katrina eventually saw Islam for the Muhammad-centered pagan nonsense that it is, and she shared that with her boyfriend.
I saw Christian Prince, but it was basically like at the end of our relationship. I was watching some video when he was drawing on the screen, and I took my notebook and I was drawing with him. He was explaining something about that verse when the angels and all the believers and Allah, everyone that prays on Muhammad to Muhammad or whatever. And then I made this painting. I mean, it's not like painting, it's basically like a map. When we met, I actually came and said, why everything is about Muhammad? And he was like, what? So I brought my art and I said, okay, my friend, in the center we have here Muhammad, okay? You can see it. This is Muhammad. So we have here Allah, then we have here believers, and then we have here Angel Jibreel. Why everyone, you know, you can see everyone is focused about this dot here, which is Muhammad. Why the whole world is about this? Remember, my ex was looking and it was obvious, you know. I was like, what's this? This is a religion?
Long story short, Katrina and her boyfriend eventually broke up, and now she's sharing the gospel with Muslims and helping Christian women make wise choices about whom they should marry. She's been posting videos for about a year and a half. At first, she was just reposting videos from other channels. Then, at the end of 2020, she started making her own videos. Her most recent video, the one some of you sent me, is titled, Before You Say I Do to a Muslim, My Testimony. It's a long video, over 90 minutes. She goes into a lot of detail about living and working in the United Arab Emirates and how everything unfolded with her relationship. The link to that video is in the description box. Be sure to check it out and subscribe. Also, because of the path that she's chosen, Katrina is going to be a target of a lot of online harassment and abuse. So be sure to have our sisters back. Before I close out, let me speak to Katrina directly. Awesome video, sister. It's amazing that you're taking everything you learned during your relationship and using it to help other people. Couldn't be prouder of you. I do want to warn you that the more effective you are in what you've decided to do, the more certain people are going to come after you. And the way they'll come after you is very different from the way they'll come after me. They call me names, but they'll call you worse names. They threaten to kill me, but they won't just threaten to kill you. They'll threaten to rape you as well. You're going to end up with a ton of online stalkers whose entire goal in life is to make you as uncomfortable as possible and to harass you into silence. Just ask any of the ex-Muslim women who have to deal with these guys online. These guys will try anything and everything to see what works against you. They'll be looking for your weaknesses, and as soon as they figure out what your weaknesses are, they'll use them to try to silence you. The positive side is that if you can handle the threats, the harassment, the online stalking, if you can take everything they throw at you, you'll be unstoppable. Now, I do have one minor point of criticism before I go. Your videos are pretty low resolution. They're 720. That's on the lower end, especially since lots of people now watch YouTube videos on giant flat screen TVs in their living room. That's not terribly important. The most important thing is having good content. But once you make a video, it's on the internet forever, so it's good to make your videos high quality. Why am I saying this? Because I'm pretty accurate in my predictions, and if you've thought everything through, and you've decided that this is going to be your ministry, I predict that Christmas is going to come early this year and that I and my fans will be happy to chip in and get you a 4K camera and a professional mic and professional lights for your future videos. So let us know if you want an equipment upgrade. We've got you covered, and we're all looking forward to seeing where your channel goes.